Good evening, everyone! And this is Anonymous speaking from deep, deep inside, within the hidden chambers in undisclosed location. Welcome! My name is Donis, this is Hacknet Release Stream, and this music is so copyrighted that I will get tons of bad things coming my way, but this is Underworld. And the song is Cowgirl, and this is one of the music tracks from the Hackers movie. Anyways, I'm here. This is not needed yet. Hey, hello, good evening, everyone. Happy birthday, Chris. I wish you a very, very pleasant rest of the day today, and in general you're an awesome person. We love you all. We all love you. Yeah, that's how it should have been said. And I wish you to achieve everything that you wished for in the next year. So I'm sorry for my maybe tiredness or something like that. I just counted that this is my sixth stream in a row, which is unbelievably incredibly a lot. And I just quit the game without good reason. Oh my god, and I don't have... Let's just launch it very fast. Yeah, this is the game. So my sixth stream, which is a lot, and it's like 5 days in a row, oh my god. And I had two streams in a day yesterday, so I'm a bit challenged, and I think this is the last... Oh, no, this is not the last stream this week. I will be on Sunday. Anyways, enough about me. Welcome everyone in the chat. Hello, Dark Tedalus. Atskana, Aturuksu, welcome. Video Game Carnage versus Mike. And I saw someone cheering for Lietuva, which is... where is that guy? Vabla Drakonash. Tell me, Vabla, are you... Where are you from? Do I have some natives in my stream? That will be very, very awesome. I usually don't have people from Lithuania here, but yeah, that would be very, very awesome. Crazy Wacko has cookies. Nice. AKGFB. Damn it, I did not still learn that. I need some evening free. Yay, Kretinga! Labas vakaras, Kretinga! Sveikas atvykas į GOG. I will not talk anymore in Lithuania because other people will not understand that at all. But yeah, that's very nice to have you, man. Welcome to GG. Cool, okay, enough of this because I will be seriously copyrighted a lot. So, this is Hacknet. The reason why you saw actually a Spotify link right here, and I will just start the music right now, is that basically Hacknet doesn't have kind of a soundtrack. So, it has one song, and it kind of loops over and it's very, very boring. So I just found this. I think that free music to play according to Twitch. So this will be some drum and bass arena from the last year. And yeah, let me see. Let me say it. Let me know if this will be not too loud. Okay, because I need some background music for my ears to play a game. Hey, Grivix, how are you doing, man? Cool! Hacknet. Some background. I'm a developer myself, so I'm really familiar with Linux and how it works from inside, and I'm developing for web, so I know the web technologies quite well, and these games are always a very fun thing for me to play with because I know a lot in the technologies and I see how the games are presenting that. So this is the background, and my one of the favorite games was Uplink, of course, and I don't know if any game matches that, so we'll try this. It's a pretty decent game. I like the idea of it. I don't like some parts of it, but we'll see that throughout the game. Atskana says, ideally you'd play Wipeout while playing that song. Which one? This one or the previous one? Anderson. EX Anderson says Hacknet has multiple songs. In fact, you can hack into a server in the Music Shuffler server. If I will find this Music Shuffler server, I will definitely play songs from Hacknet. For some reason, I just, you know, for me has was that it was the same song. So, no worries. You will see. Let us begin the new session. Let us name us. Hackerman, of course. Very secure password, of course. This is confirmed. This is kind of represents the Linux boot sequence. Kind of. Ah, the Underworld, yeah. So, we have a lot of text in this game, and I mean a lot of text, and this will be a lot of reading. I will probably not read everything. Oh, I thought it was a game. Crap. Yeah, I know, but you know, when I'm working and when I'm actually doing some stuff, I usually listen to drum and bass, and it kind of keeps me up for most of the time. Yeah, so we'll go through tutorial. Oh my god, I wish I could have turned this off somehow. Oh, actually I can, but do I have the console? No, I don't have the console yet. Darn it. Okay, so this game is about hacking, and you're basically breaking up into some servers and deleting files, changing them, changing some data, everything around changes are... Oh yes, I saw this as a different skin and I thought, oh my god, my layout just broke. Yeah, so... Why is that not showing console? I'm not used to clicking on that. So we have this one machine, which is Hacker NPC, and which is now locked. Oh, okay, this is unlocked. Nice. So eventually you have the console in here, right? And this is your terminal or console or whatever you want to call. And basically, we are using Linux commands. So, for example, we type ls and we see all the file system in here. We type ps and we see all the running processes. There are also some commands like scan, for example. So, we have this... I think that's this server, right? Yeah. Yeah, so there are more and more commands. We can change directories to, like, for example, log. We can remove files from this log. It takes pretty much a long time to do that. But I will just kill the tutorial. Ta-da! Tutorial skip. You see? Hacking the game already from the first time. G-Pudding says, I thought you were into... Why do I have stars on words? Versus Mike thought I'm from Finland. No, I'm from Lithuania. It's near the Baltic Sea also, so. Christy X4 says Hackerman PC is a bad name if you want to disguise yourself as not being the hacker. But no, sometimes the most obvious is the most unobvious. Can I type rm-rf/? Ha! This one doesn't take commands. Doesn't take arguments. Sorry, but I can remove this. I can't remove this. Home. No, I can't. Thank you, IronCore45, for following us. Welcome to the GOG family. Actual command line. Yes, this is kind of actual command line. What did I want to say? I wanted to say that we are aiming for 25,000 followers, and we're organizing a very, very big giveaway on that occasion. So, why is my screen flashing? Is it the email? Oh my god. We have an email program, which is called gmail.com. Jmail. So, yeah, there will be a big giveaway when we reach 25k. So, oh look, and Chris wrote to us. It's from Bit. Just misses an 8. So follow us. Please do that. We do a lot of stuff, and you will have an opportunity to win maybe one, maybe two, maybe five, maybe 10 games. Who knows? Just keep it in. And what do you think about this? Wait. So, what kind of words are censored in Twitch right now? Maybe copy you random to the SDA. No, I will not. And ironically, let me just check that very quickly. Ironically, this game actually does not have a Linux version. Yeah. What do you think about this game? Is this a Linux simulator? No, it does use a lot of stuff. Does it use Nmap? Oh yes, it does use Nmap. Very nice. Yeah, but it's not the simulator, right? Okay, let's see our first contact from Bit. Hi, I don't know you, and I'm sad to say that I will never will, but if you're reading this, it means you might be the only person that can make things right. So there's some kind of a story in this game. This is the Bit who is actually in some kind of problem, and we kind of are helping him. Oh, right. About RAM and why notes are taking a lot of RAM. This is in this place we have our process list. And for example, if I would do I have a shell somewhere? No. I'll just run Nmap on this server. I don't have any software. Anyways, if you run your processes, they're kind of queued in here quite nicely. And look at this. I have this note, right? The Hacknet navigation guide. And observe this little text. This is used RAM. So I'm opening a note and I'm using 255 megabytes of RAM out of 761 megabytes of RAM. Who in his right mind nowadays has 761 megs of RAM? Who? Really? This pencil might have 2 gigs put in, and just because. Why? So yeah, if I close the note, you know, everything is not used, then voila. But we need that. Do we need that? No, we don't need that. We need I have to delete the tracer from my. Okay, yeah. So you can play this game in two ways. You can either, you know, click on stuff and use a mouse and just, you know, do whatever you want to do. With the other hand, or you can type everything in console and as a normal guy just drop the mouse and use both of your hands to do the proper job. Not the one hand. So we'll use the mouse. Yeah, we will not use the mouse. There will be no mouse using. So I will be focusing on the console here. Yeah, we have to remove this file. If you press tab, basically you have auto completion. So it's kind of easy to type the commands because you have the help command also, and it lists all of possible commands, almost all. You have even the command to open CD tray and close the CD tray. I wonder if actually it works with the PCs which have a CD tray. We can reboot, we can replace something, we can analyze stuff. Let's see, help 3. Yeah, login, upload, clear, there. Basically, in this game, you are doing missions, and all the missions are being done via Jmail. So basically, you just click reply and send an empty email, and you know, it just gives you another mission. Further on in the game, we will see that this is also, there are a couple of places where you can get missions, as for example bulletin boards or something like that. Is it like uplink? I don't know. I really don't know. It's a very different game. It takes a different approach, and it's basically it's different. The idea is the same, but it's really, really different. Uplink was the daddy of all the hacking games. And really, it was unbeatable, I think, up until this day. It's really like that, but not as that. In Uplink, for example, you could upgrade your hardware, right? You could get better connections, you could get more RAM, you could get... really, you felt like you're doing something in terms of upgrading yourself and earning money. And in here, you actually don't have the money. This is one of the main differences. You don't have any money at all. So this is more mission based, and this is more story based game. So it's very, very different. I think, Donis, where in the world can you find a notepad that takes up 300 megabytes when all it has is like 6 lines of texts? Yes, this is what I was talking about. It's insane, and you can't have like 5 notes opened up with your own notes, because you can't write notes. Because it takes all the freaking RAM out of you, and that's it. Right? Does this take place in modern day or years ago when people had less RAM? Actually, Lightspeeder, I don't know. I don't know. I kind of didn't think about that. For me, it sounds like it's modern days, because... yeah. Kind of feels like that. I don't know. Use OpenCD tray. I can write it. OpenCD tray. Oh, I'm in the wrong server, sorry. I have to open mine. Nothing happens. Close CD. Wait. Nope. Nothing happens. Oh well. Admiral Doc asks, can you apt-get install NetHack and play that in Hacknet? I think apt-get is not a command. But there is a game inside the game. I will show you that. Why is OpenCD3 not called Eject like in real life? I don't know, come on. Lazy Jake is trying to write all the commands in there. Okay, let's go through some story, and right, so great, that should keep me safe, because it removed one file, though there was no process running. Yeah, but for me it's you know, for me it's really, really hard to say something good or something bad about this game, because it tries to emulate something that I know very well, and you know, it's for me it's just funny. For me it's funny in a way, because it just, I cannot use it as I use it each day, because it just lacks a lot from that each day. I'm not saying it's a bad game, but it's just I'm used to that, so it's very hard for me to judge that. For people who don't know who it is, I think it's a very nice game. Just it shows a lot in terms of for example, what is going on in the servers, which they're browsing every day, you know, This is what happens inside any kind of web page you're actually browsing. Christiak says, Apatoget, sorry, but RPM is greater than APT. Are you kidding me? We cannot be friends anymore. I'm sorry. Yeah, so basically, you get an email, you add some servers, you have some information about. You see, I opened two nodes, 500 megabytes of RAM, gone. God, just gone. I don't know who counted that, I'm sorry. Yeah, so you get all the tutorials in terms of what to do. Oh my god, the actual notepad is weighing 32 megs. This is insane. I'm gonna rant about this RAM problem all the game, seriously. Okay, I'm just looking for what do we have to do here. Right, before we start, you're going to need a few things. Port hack alone is just not going to cut it. Most of the modern computers will find. Yeah, so we basically have to hack this one. So it goes like this. You click on a server, you kind of scan it. You know, you can use a map, or you can use scan probe. So you see a list of ports. These are the standard ones. There are also some database servers and something more in there, like and you have amount of ports you need to crack. So for example, I have this I don't have SSH. Why don't I have SSH? Was it in this? Wait a minute. Oh no, I can just hack it like this. Yeah, so you use port hack and bam, you're inside the server, right? Does it have anything in? No, it just has a config. Okay, this is some kind of config. I don't know what it is, but oh well. So this server doesn't have any good software. It has tons of logs. Also, what this game has is a lot of info from a lot of stuff from bash.org, and bash.org is just a very good place to read a lot of stuff what people on IRC are talking about. Do you guys remember IRC? Is anyone using it right now? Oh, even Control C doesn't work. Oh man. Okay, let's just disconnect that. Yeah, I really don't like this netmap. Later in the game, it gets more and more clustered with information and nodes. And believe me, it's very hard to find what you need afterwards. So we just ran this port hack program, which is basically hacks inside into the server, right? And we're in the server. Mostly all the action is being done in home directory or in the bin directory. So we have this SSH crack, for example. So we just run scp to copy it to our local folder, and we'll have an SSH crack program in our PC or machine or however you want to call this. Christiax is using IRC to connect to Twitch. Awesome, I'm also. G-Pudding asks if I'm a real life hackerman. No, I'm not. Do I use Linux at work? I use Mac at work. Yeah, everyone is Mac crazy, so we use OS X. I hate OS X, really. After using it for a year, it's just a bloody bad system to work with, believe me. Christiak says, so you can't hack a stack of credit card infos and buy a decent PC with more than 600 RAM in the game? Yes, you basically cannot buy it in the game, like, you cannot buy anything in the game at all. So this is the point, right? Mazayu says, some people still use mailing lists. Yeah, I use mailing lists also, come on. But nowadays, IRC is so quiet. I've checked, like, I've joined in our Lithuanian IRC network, and there was like total, I think, 100 people online. 100 people online in IRC. It was never like this. Never. This is incredibly, I don't know. It's, this technology just died. But I really, 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 really would like to have it back because I hate Skype. Cool. So was it it? We had just to copy the SSH crack. Yeah, so you can usually know all the information here. For example, there is some proxy server. Can I actually connect to that? 109.59.49.30. Ooh. All right. Ooh, we need a proxy to pass a proxy here. So basically, a lot of servers are protected by proxies, right? And the one thing you can do is you run a shell in some hacked machine, right? So we have this Viper battle station, and we have Opal software hacked, right? So we run two shells in there. Shells are basically remotes. Oh no, I will not explain what shells are. Always clean your logs. So we have this entropy test server, and it's actually protected by proxy, right? So we can basically overload this proxy, and then we can... Oh, come on, why my SSH crack is not working? Why did SSH crack just download into the... Oh, now I had... Oh my god, I just messed something up. In SSH crack. Okay. Move SSH crack exit to /bin /SSH crack.exe. Damn it. Ah, okay, now it works. Damn. Yep. So we have a bypass proxy, we run SSH crack, provided the port number 22, and there's magic happening right now, and it's being hacked, and no one knows about this except for all you people there. So please be silent. Yeah, and we run port hack, and this will actually crack the server. Am I running the latest version? Yes, I am running the latest version. And actually, yeah, let me check the notes really quick, because I remember that it had updates, but I did not check what it updated. Oh, but I don't have... There's no changelog for Hacknet! No! What the hell? Okay, so I don't know what changed. I'm sorry. I have no idea what changed. I wish I knew. Because in previous version, when I just SCP'd the exe, it basically downloaded it straight to the bin. So probably it's just... probably right now I have to specify where to do this. Oh well. What do we have here? entropy induction test. Congratulations, download this file to... Okay. SCP... entropy induction test to home. Okay. So, okay, what else do we have? We have something in bin. We have bit. Please read. Please read. Bit, if you're lurking, can you please come out of the shadows? I need to talk to you. Vapor won't get off my case saying something is wrong. She saw something going on. Let me know. T. So there are these characters in this game. Like, you have Bit, you have Vapor, you have T. And there are many more actually appearing. And they're just progressing through the story. So this is... yeah, and they have all the bits and pieces of... really, you have to read all of this because it's really, really nice. Like, e-admins are lazy.txt, for example. No one ever remembers to clear out the bin folder too. This is a test service scrubs. It's designed for people to break in. At least tidy up. Yeah, so the bin folder is full of bunch of stuff. Some OP Stormwind. So it's fun sometimes to read stuff. Let's clear our logs. Okay, so probably... DX Anderson streamed for 5 hours, including breaks. And... he also read out many logs, mails, and etc. Yeah, guys, I will not read all the mails and all the logs. There's tons of reading, and I'm really afraid to have the same destiny as Chris had with his voice, because I feel that it's reached a limit where I can feel something. So yeah. Hey, Oster, welcome. It's like my friend hosting World of Warcraft private server and shapeshifting himself into Onyxia. Oh my god, those servers were so buggy, actually. Okay, so... to be honest, I always forget what I have to do. Oh, so I did this already. So, Bit is kind of... Wait, so I did this also. Bitwise test. Okay, I'll have a Bitwise test. Oh, he wants me to break in some old server. Ooh, and I just advanced the game in terms of story because I just hacked the entropy server and I passed their test. Ha! This is awesome. This is amazing. Yeah, but we can hack the Bitwise PC also. Dude. We use SSH crack 22. Yes, Discra, it's... it's not a combination of P words and P word and donis, it's just P D replaced with P. Just one letter, right? Right, so what do we have in this server? Nothing in bins. Test file. In the death zone. Congratulations, you win! Awesome. Some seize files. I don't know what seize files actually do. Autolog reports. Let's read some of them. These are all logs from IRCs or somewhere like that. There's some kind of creative writing assignment too, which is a huge bunch of text, and I have no idea what it is. I never read it. It's just too much for me to read in the game. What else? Remember to scan your surroundings all the time that you're hacking. For example, if you hack the server, just run scan, and it sometimes shows nearby servers. It's kind of pretty easy when you get this. It's just natural. For example, all the time you have to clear the logs, right? So it's just you're doing this naturally all the time after playing it for some time. Okay, does he want actually? Okay, so this is it from Bit. He does not want us to do anything more? Or should I reply to him? Mission complete. Okay, I honestly have no way of knowing if you succeeded in this responder, but if you're seeing this, it means you at least you found something. I'm going to assume something really useful. You should try breaking an old breaking one of my old test servers of Viper, if Viper had the sort of thing he's known for getting lying around. You should have everything you need to get in. Remember, any non-basic programs you get need a port number to run, like this. SSH crack 22, yeah. Just find the port you want to crack and run it on that. So probably not. Did I miss something in the server itself? No, the C's bin. There is Hope's terminal guide. Also some help. I don't have any music stuff, which is pretty sad. No, okay, so I'm disconnecting from the... Oh, video game corners. Did I receive a mission? Yeah, I did receive a mission. Okay. Yes, My Little Ponies. This is what I'm known for. I ran 300 people WoW server on a 1 megabit 256 kilobit connection flawlessly. I mean, it buggy in terms of quests, and when there was like a huge rise of those fake servers, they kind of, you know, tried to copy all the quests that there were in WoW. And they were really like quests which had "this is a quest" text. And it was like, okay, so what do I have to do? I don't know. Just no one cared about that. It just went somewhere, whatever. I don't know. Austro just remembered that she forgot to apply for a refund for FNAF. What is FNAF? Lazy J7 just wrote. How to get Hacknet from GOG. Okay, so let's read what we have to do. A tabloid news server, which is /bot, has recently taken a negative stance towards Entropy, which is this little hacking group that we are in right now, and we'd like to temporarily disable their operation. As a second test of your skill, we ask you to bring down this server's message board. If you can, leave the non-Entropy related articles and the rest of the server intact. not wish to end needlessly destructive. So they're kind of white hat hacker group. If you don't know, there are like black hats, white hats, and gray hats. White hats are the ones who are hacking, but they are always reporting what they find. So they never do it for money, they do never do it for fame, they do it for good cause. Let's say it like that. Black hats are the complete opposite of them. So they're usually hidden somewhere, you know, you don't find them, and they are doing that for money, basically. And this is their part of the living, right? They're hacking stuff, and they are... Oh, this is a Gmail. I don't need a Gmail. They're stealing your credit card information. They are breaking into systems and just making money out of that. And gray hats are basically, let's say, gray hats are a middle between white hats and black hats. They kind of sometimes act from the good cause, but sometimes also they are doing that for money. Okay, so we have to remove some news articles, which is in this very simple file system. It doesn't really look like that in real life, but... So I think we have to take two... Wait, do we need to take is your data at risk also? I don't see anything with entropy in this article. I think that's it. I think that is it. Yeah, Mazaius, you are correct. White hat is Gandalf and black hat is Saruman. That's basically... No, we need to disconnect. We need to connect to Gmail. Jmail. No, mission incomplete, so I forgot to do something. No. This is some news about new Microsoft phone. Yeah? Microsoft. So what else? Did I miss something? Did I actually miss something? No, there's logs, bins, there's... Oh, right. Wait. Yes. I have to disable their system. So, we are just moving configs to hacked by Ackerman. Jesus, what I'm writing. I'm so evil right now. Yay! Critical error. Null sys file. Alright. Unhandled EO exception. Oh my. Yay! And mission successful. So we are in the entropy. I did too much and I forgot to do something. Yeah. Chris is planning to. ChristyX4 is planning to stream it. Or about what? Memories in 8-bit says, my family was literally waiting on the phone for me to finish my stream. Yeah, these are the good priorities, man. Oh well, that happens, right? That happens. So much activity today in the chat. Oh my, guys, you're on fire. Panzer Jaggerif asks, does GOG have any of the old Doom games? Doom? I don't know what are the old Doom games. Oh, you were considering to do Revenant. Yeah, Revenant is a very interesting case. Classical was trying to do that for the whole day today, actually, for you guys. And there is something up, probably with the combination of his system, because Video Game Carnage ran this very well. I started this before, right before the stream, actually. And it was cool. It really worked. So, I don't know, I didn't get into the game, but at least I could see the menu and I just ran it, so I have no idea how it was it good or not. Yep, so we are in the Entropy group, and I resolved my first contract. Yay, let's drink to that! This is water. As a small welcoming gift, you'll find this user details of the admin account to our asset server. Yeah. They're giving out admin accounts. My god. Hacker group giving out admin accounts. Really, but just ignore me laughing from this, because I already disclosed myself that I know a lot about this stuff, and it just funny for me it's just funny. Like, you know, when, I don't know, some dancer goes to, we'll see a game about dancing where you have to click two buttons just to make your character dance, right? So that would be funny for him also. Or, for example, as Mario is for plumbers. Cool, so I have this, no, but I don't have to complete any mission. Yeah, we have the asset server, we can log in actually to it. We have the data, so let's see what they have in the bin. FTP bounce, nice. I need FTP bounce. Okay, so you have to actually specify where you want to copy the file. Cool. Let's see what is there in the logs. Nothing in the logs. Oh man, it doesn't have Control C, and I always type that when I make a mistake and retype the command again. So the mantra of entropy, and again, they are kind of the white hat hacker group. So entropy mantra: our group is founded on three pillars, which we strive to follow in all things. First, strive for justice and righteousness in all things. Second, create and share more than you destroy. Third, never have an excuse not to improve. Entropy will deny contracts that go against these pillars and remove agents that violate them. Oh, so I'm an agent right now. Ooh. I need some black glasses, but I don't have them. Have backups. It's a new folder. Nothing interesting. Let's remove the locks and disconnect. Should I actually reply to them? Ah, okay. So also we have a contract database. Yeah, so this is what I was talking about. We will have contracts. And these are our available contracts which we can do. So, yeah. So basically, this is like the start of the game, and from here you already take the contracts and do some more hacking stuff, and then you have more advanced stuff, and probably I will just log out from this and log in into my actual gameplay account, which I will show the more advanced stuff, because I'm much more deeper in the game. So, you know, already have like tons of programs of hacking. I had cases of tracing myself, and this is where it gets more interesting, because right now these contracts are just to get you familiar with all the game, right? So let me just quickly do that. Let me reboot. I like the reboot sequence. One Billion Hex asks if the game has SSH port always on 22. Yes, it does. Which kind of is... What rebooting requires admin access? Oh, my PC. I need to reboot my PC. Yes. Yeah, it kind of does. At least as far as I know, it kind of does. What do you want to... What do you actually imagine, like, this game will be? What do you think, Gok Ping is Pong. Yeah, you can run the OpenCD tray, but, wait, can I log out? I can't log out. How do I actually disconnect? Well, I can disconnect from the server. Don't tell me I have to actually, like... But I just want to log out. Why do I have to quit the game? I don't want to quit the game, dude. Freaking games, man. Freaking games. Right. So let's boot up my account virtual machine. Ouster ate Pyrofox's knees? What the fuck, Ouster? Shut down the server now. Oh, come on. Aliases are nice. Why are you displaying this for me right now? I went through this. I know your name is Bit. And you're dead. But somehow you're emailing me stuff. No fucking way. This is not my save. This is not my freaking save. God! Really? So, you want to say... Okay, let me try this in a different way, because I think I know what the problem is. I found a bug, yeah, that's for sure. Yes, someone hacked my save! Is this game like infected or something like that? Oh my god. No! I don't have my save. No, game, why the... Why do you do this? Are you kidding me? I don't remember my password. No, but it's like... What? What? Do you see these guys? It's like, why does it want to start from the beginning? I don't want to start from the beginning. Did I forgot to click save? Oh my god, seriously? Now I'm mad. Come on, who deletes save files? Fuck you, game. Really? Really, on stream right now, I have like none? So I just like... The game just deleted 3 hours of my game. 3 freaking hours. And I wanted to show you guys what the hell is waiting for you. But no, let's delete everything. No, it's really gone. Maybe I have to hack back into my save game. Yeah, I wish I would if I had actually a place to do that from. Freaking tutorial, man. Freaking tutorial. I don't know, guys. Oh man, really? But you see, I open just like the save file, and I see that I have a proper save file. But for some reason, I don't. And for example, for a Hackerman, it's also tutorial complete. Something is fishing here. I don't know, chat. I have no idea, really. I'm lost right now, and don't understand why it doesn't want to show me my proper save, even from the game before. I just played an hour of the game. Where's my game? Okay. This works. This doesn't work. Okay, so sorry, I cannot show you that because I just messed up something and it doesn't want to show the games. So, oh my god, sorry. And doesn't show the game also. What? Yeah, now it shows. Okay, yeah, so I see the... I know the save files are in there, but there's something else connected with the... actually, the way you launch the game. And the thing I did, that first I launched it via Galaxy client, and then I exited it because I wanted to switch the account. And then I launched it from just, you know, from the client... not command line, but from the start menu, just by searching for the game. And it probably started in some different way, and it cannot read the save files anymore from before. So something is messed up here in terms of which client you're launching. And I launched with the Galaxy client again and opened the Hackerman's save file, which started the tutorial again, but I already finished the tutorial. So something in this case is messed up. So anyways, I'll just continue with the save. At least I have this one. Sorry again. Yeah, I was actually checking out the save files inside. They're actually pretty nice. They have this save accounts meta, which actually probably something is messed up in here. Ooh, maybe I can hack that. Oh my god. So this is the... Okay, the save file is really nice. You have to check this, guys. Seriously. I will not open it on stream, but yeah. No, they're both in my dir- anyways, whatever. Let's continue. Okay, so damn it, I wanted to show this. Okay, so let's get some contracts. Point clicker. A well-meaning client needs some data of his game server to delete it to regain productivity. Oh, this is, by the way, the game I was telling about, which is Point Clicker, and this is the idle game, and we can click. For a lot of time. We can install auto clicker and then click it again. We can upgrade auto clicker and click again. So it's actually, if you're bored with the game or something like that, you know, you can just click. You can buy auto clicker version 2 and then upgrades. It's actually very similar to the game which is called Cookie Clicker, I think. No, Christix, no, it's not the admin stuff. I will probably write something about that, so yeah. We'll see. Okay, so the thing is that we have to actually remove the mengsk handle from this point clicker. So let us scan the server and see what's inside. Okay, we need two open ports to crack. Alright, we have the SSH crack and we have the FTP bounce, which we can use on port 21, and I can run both of those programs in the same time. So for example, in some servers you have to crack 4 ports, and probably later in the game you have even more ports to hack, which starts to become a management issue, how you actually are running the cracking programs and in what direction. Video King Connor says, big fan of the music. Yeah, nice to hear that. I am also. This keeps me alive today. Because the SP just read insufficient donis. When did you read that? Which is better, this one or uplink? It's really, really a hard question to answer. Uplink is very, very different, and honestly I like uplink better than this one. I like this one because it is closest to reality, like I think the closest game to reality from all of Hacking Apes, because there was uplink, there was hacker Light, I think, Elite, I don't remember, there were some more, but these are the three basically ones that I do recall. Yeah, so this one is closest to reality in terms of what you're doing, and you know, all the IP addresses, the structure of the file system, the commands, the ports, the names, and blah blah. This is closest to reality. But still, in uplink, you have much more feeling of achievement. Like, if you hack something, you have a return from that. You can upgrade your hardware. You can have faster CPU to run faster hacks. You can have more RAM to put stuff in. And it's like, in here, you have these tools, right? And you have this story going on, but the story is kind of difficult to track, in my opinion, and it's really, really, really interesting approach. I really do appreciate this game, and big shout out to devs that they created this. It's I think it's not an easy topic on which you can't create a game. It's really, really hard to actually create a game in which most of the gamers that will try this game actually can understand that. So this is my opinion. XDSPC is a girl in a red dress in that code. No SFTP. Bubble Dragonash hates clicker games. Yeah, they're just a waste of time, come on. Important readme, do not crash. It's system critical, removing it will crash, okay. So let's go to saves, and we have to remove the main GS key save. Yep, we did that. That's it. Clearing the logs. And we can disconnect actually, and the logs are being cleared also, which is a pretty interesting thing that is happening. Yeah, we just replied to this email, and we have just hacked. Not hacked, but I'm sorry, but completed the task. So let's get another one. The famous counter hack. Let's just do it. I hope I'll get into some interesting way. A company PP Marketing recently hired a freelance hacker to break into rival company servers to retrieve some sensitive data, which we believe to be a mailing list, delete it on their end and transfer it to the hiring group. So we will have to transfer it where? To the entropy servers. Okay. So, PP Marketing, what do you have running? You have proxies. We can run a shell here. And we can run a shell here. It actually doesn't matter on which servers you run the shell. At least you have, if you have a couple of them, it's this one. What I don't like about this game, for example, you know, that you have to probe the servers all the time, even if you have a connection to them. Right, we need to overload this. Oh, someone's tracing me. Oh shit, I have to act quickly. So I can do SSH crack, and I have to do FTP crack. Of course, you know. 21, yeah. Basically, if you will try to run another command, you will get the insufficient memory error. Yeah, but about the trace, it's like, it's a funny trace. 90 seconds, come on. Yes, Admiral Doc, it is a possibility, because I don't know. Stuff happens, you know. Modern day technology. So, as I said, you usually have everything in the home directory, and our task said that it might be something around the mailing list, so probably this is it. This is the mailing list we got from the hacker, who charged through the nose, by the way. I don't know what that expression means, actually. He charged through the nose. What, he just accepted the credit card through the nose. So we have to download this. Secure mailing list deck. And we can probably do this. Oh, by the way, pro tip, if you are being traced, just disconnect from the server, reconnect again, and the trace will be gone. Easy as that. Can I reply to them with this? When you reply to emails, you can add additional details. And these additional details are, for example, some texts, some password or something like that. Where do I have to upload this? Delete it on their end and front. Did I delete it? Oh crap, I forgot to delete. Ha 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 ha. Lame. I thought I deleted that. Oh man. You see, I'm, for example, for from my memory, I'm trying to navigate through these directories, like, you know, cd, wander up, then to workspace, but it doesn't work because it doesn't alt tab, and you know, it's a very basic shell. It's like so basic shell that, oh my god. Logs equals death, says money 12351. 123451, yeah. Format C works all the time though. Nope. Nah, it doesn't recognize the command. So did we actually finish this? Okay, this is cool. So there's some kind of ranking in this game, like your current ranking is 60 out of 100. But I kind of don't understand what does it mean in this game. I don't know. Microsoft Solutions, loose ends. Hackers stole valuable company data they have been taken care of, but what they stole needs to be removed. Okay, I can do that. It's easy. We just need to... Ooh, we're being traced. Yeah, so in general, this game is all about this, what I'm doing for the hour and a half. You're just taking contracts, reading stuff, running these commands and hacking the servers. Which is fun for a while. I don't know if it's actually fun for a long time, for a really long time. But probably, some people enjoy these games, and I don't really blame them or you know, say that this game is pretty bad or something like that. No, it's a nice little game. Ooh, we have the EOS device scanning. Nice. Hey, Screaming Joypad, welcome. How about FDisk or MX? Make file system. Yeah, I mean, yeah, stage 78 says that this game looks cool and it's kind of realistic. I agree and I disagree at the same time. Really, I would say that you need a different point of view about this game from a person who has no freaking idea what, for example, F-Disc is, right? Or, well, probably F-Disc will be the main thing which will differentiate people. And what's the difference between F-Disc in Windows and in Linux? Do we have actually where to copy this? Is it in the asset server? Where's the asset server? Yeah, it is here. Okay, iOS. Copy EOS to bin. Do we have something else? No, we don't have anything else. So, right now with this mission, we'll try to hack the EOS device. And in terms of realism, it actually takes some pretty serious issues which were happening for the past time. So I will just open that email in a jiffy and I will tell what's happening in there. So basically, how do you hack into EOS devices? Here's the trick. Because EOS users don't get access to the terminal on their own device, all the admin passwords are the same across the entire product range. And this happened with basically all the routers that you have in your home. They have the same password, all of them. So it's Alpine, and you actually just enter admin and the password Alpine, and you're in any EOS device in this game. So can I upgrade my hacking kit? No, unfortunately I cannot upgrade my hacking kit, and I'm stuck with 761 megabytes of RAM, which in my opinion is just a piece of bullshit. So now what I did intentionally, I was running this SSH crack and the FTP bounce programs on the server, right? And then I opened the email, and in theory this kind of should be already open. Yes, they are open. Thank you very much, game. Is this a joke on Cisco iOS or Apple iOS? This is on Apple, because this is EOS. And we just hacked into Jason's PowerBook Plus. Yeah, so we just run this new little program called EOS Device Scan, and it will try to find his phone. Probably need to push the pedal to the metal. What? iOS is safer. Apple iOS root password is really Alpine. You're serious? I don't believe anything was stolen. They were probably. So I have found some phone. Let me just to connect to Jason's e-phone, which has a very similar model and a very similar looks, right? E-phone 4S. What can I upgrade? Nothing. I have no upgrades, and I lost my save on top of that. So there is EOS Connection Manager, of course. Oh wait, I have to log in. Admin, Alpine, ta-da, we're in. Okay, so what do I have to do? What do I have to do? I have to get the password to the owner's email account. One which we know he has synced to the device. Okay, so we have a we need the password from the email. Let's see. Is it an AOS? Mail. Yep, here's the email. Oh, cat gg stacks at gmail.com. Yep, here it is. Password in plain text. Tintin7. Yep, so we what we do is we just reply, we add the additional details and put the password and send it off. And we have a successful contract. Yeah, so my current ranking is 19 of 100, which is... I still don't know what it is. Please explain me, someone, what the f*** is this ranking? Is this music in-game? No, this is not music in-game. This is from Drum and Bass Arena 2014 album. And I hope I can stream it. If not, then whatever. Sorry. Sorry, guys. Because in-game, I can actually show this. Let me just pause this. I will press save not to kill my data. The game has its music, right? Something about here. So it's like this. I can play it for a while. I'll just make it a bit lower. I don't know why you need three numbers after the... point, but let it be. And I think, or at least when I last played that, it was really really repetitive for me, and that's my opinion. It was just repetitive for me, and I just turned that off because it yeah, why is chatty showing the bloody stars and stuff? Low on RAM, just download more. Yes. Sure. Where the hell I can download that? Okay, so this was a successful contract. Oh, this is empty. Why is it empty? Oh, because this is the wrong server. Ha ha ha. So, for example, in all the phones that you're hacking in, there's apps directory, right? And in the apps you have, for example, Crush 2, Smash Ninja Quest, Die Hard, Violent Saga, Small Crush, Spirit Samurai DLC and stuff. Yeah, you have notes, and for example, this guy just has a bunch of recipes and stuff. So it's, you know, it's a lot of content to actually read through. Yeah, and you can delete logs while disconnected. This is this probably should be fixed, I think. Mr. Screaming Joypad, if I'll pick my own words, no one, and I really really mean no one except for this one guy, will understand me in the chat. Bet jeigu jūs taip norite, aš galiu naudoti savo žodžius. Ir sakyti po perkūnais. Now please try to repeat that, Mr. Screaming Joypad. Po perkūnais. And you can try that on your stream also. Maybe the log deletion is done with no hub by default. Yeah, probably. But then you can't. You will still have your connection in the logs. To be honest, this log deletion is not so done well. Okay, what should I pick in terms of contracts? Back to school. No, I don't want to school. A bit of a strange request. Someone exceptionally well funded. Funded? Someone exceptionally well funded. Is this a word? Funded? I know funded, but funded this? Asked for some help in investigating a co-worker's tablet to see if it's being used for personal matters at work. Okay. Sale for Hollow Point Deck Con Ori. A client of ours recently purchased a valuable piece of software and is refusing to pay. Delete what they now unjustly hold. Okay, we can do that. Can be a badass. Yay, Raving Lithuanian. Yeah, awesome. I said something kunis. No, that was ho per kunis. Not kunis. Okay, I can give you another one. Poshimt spipkiu. Oh, it should be someone extremely well-funded, but still, that's kind of strange for me. Okay, so Hollow Point Tech return policy. Let's see what they have. And I'm intentionally not doing any scans because basically there are no servers that are available. Oh Mike. Oh, you dirty Mike. Greeks, I'm not swearing at you, I'm just speaking my own language. This is how our little country is speaking back there. Oh, I already done. Any Balkans here? Okay, we're here. What do we need to delete? Wow, this is so obvious. And don't mind me mistyping all the time. It's kind of intentional in a way because since I'm using Mac at work, it's it has a different layout, and every single day my head has to rearrange itself and type in a different keyboard. So probably I think no country in the world actually can understand us. Like, you know, for example, you have Slavic root languages, which is, you know, Polish, Russian, Ukrainian, Belarusian, Czech, maybe a little bit, right? So they have these, they have a lot of stuff which is similar, and they can partially understand each other. For example, we and Latvia, which is our neighbor also, we kind of not very much understand each other. So there are two countries which kind of have similar, they have the same roots, but it's really hard for them to understand each other. Okay, this was is successful. My current ranking is 1 of 100. Yay, I still have no idea what that does. Entropy sent, aggression must be punished. So, Hackerman, you've proved yourself very capable in a very small amount of time. I'm impressed. Yeah, come on. It was so easy. Okay, so we need to delete something. Okay, from this guy called Nikes. Okay. Okay, we can delete stuff. I think, oh no, it's not this one, sorry. No, DC. DC, not CD. We need some new software. And it will be SMTP overflow. Okay. SMTP overflow to bin. Oh, labas vakaras, Raiva99. Good evening, Raiva99. Yeah, welcome. Awesome. Spread the word, guys. No, I'm really glad you joined me, because I was wondering actually whether some Lithuanians are watching this or not, and whether they are interested in the GOT as a company and as what they are doing actually, and if they are buying the GOT's games. And yeah, this is awesome, amazing. Welcome. No, I don't need to do that. Okay. Where's that server here? Proxy node X4. Okay, let's see what this guy has. So I'm hacking a hacker also. Can you also hack time? You know, you need a lot of RAM, at least 256 kilobytes. Yes, I can hack time. Latvian, it's Labas Vakars. Oh, proxy active, okay. Come on. Balkans only pirate stuff. Come on, don't say that. How about you just pick this up? Yeah, cool. Very nice. Yeah, really, I really think that this is a well-made game in terms of how realistic it is, what kind of, you know, there is some kind of story in here. The RAM, the lack of RAM is annoying, and that's for sure. But for people who are not familiar, oh my god. So did I delete this or not? I almost got caught. Oh my god, I have to do this over again. Shit. Fucking in progress. Why is the RAM gone? I don't know, because these hacking programs just use tons of RAM, and I have like, right now I have 686 running used from 761, which is, oh my god, so little. Okay. Oh damn it. So yeah, in some cases you just have to I got so many logs. In some cases you just have to be faster. Ta-da. Alright. Ooh, I got an email from Nikes. You'll find me. You're a pathetic script. And I don't know if it's intentional, but the mistypes in this are awesome. Seriously, you think you can just fuck with my stuff and live without a consequence? Do you think I could... What is happening? Why? What the f- No, I don't want this. What is happening? Okay, maybe nothing. I don't know what that is. Why are you beeping? Just show me something, game. Come on, just don't beep. This is such an awesome game for streaming if the audience doesn't mind the interface. Probably. I don't know if it's actually very nice for streaming. It has a lot of text, yeah? You know, you have to read a lot. And it's really... It's kind of strainful a bit. Because of the... It's just purely because of the amount of text you have to read. So, at least for me. So the guy is hacking me, but I, like, what can I do, right? Can I trap him? What did I do? Fuck. I just tried to trap him! What the hell, game? Oh my god. Oh my god. I will have to move myself to the side. I just got BSOD. And I'm now sitting without the X server C's, which is basically... This is so funny. Like, you know, the X server is basically used in Linux to run the graphical interface. But it's kind of an xserver.c's, which is, and C's is a Windows file. Yeah, which is kind of nice. So can I do something? Something? LazyJake7 says, I tried to delete his X server C's before he deleted mine, and I did, but it didn't work, which is a bit lame. Maybe he didn't just hack you from the same network, I don't know. Okay, so now we have to do some real console work. So in this part you have to remember what commands you have. Let's connect to this server. Did I mistype somewhere? 29.103.19. What do you mean I can't? 29.103.3. Okay. Right. Can I log in actually? Oh, but I don't have the data. But I can run the port hack. Nephew's Wayland. So, I think I'm in. So I just have to scp X server to my C's directory. I will clear the logs here. So many logs. And we just reboot. Xorg doesn't care. I'm running Lindos, yes. Apparently I am running Lindos. Oh my god, we're green right now. So hacky. So lit. Okay. So apparently we're now green. So let me just... I will leave myself there. This is a very interesting thing that basically you can change your skin or layout. Of stuff. So we're back online. Yes, they hacked my DNB as well. I just turned on the music because someone told that there are multiple tracks. So I'll play that for a while. Maybe, you know, maybe I just thought that, or maybe that was a bug, I don't know. This game received an update and it behaves a bit differently, so... just maybe a bit too loud still. For my liking, yep, okay. So, we have some new tasks. Oh, welcome Surprise Attack Games, welcome, you're a bit joined us until the 10 minutes to the game, but yeah. Yes, I know Chris that K-Win, K-Nivor K-Win was... Lindos was a thing. Yeah, I remember that they tried to actually recreate the Windows and Linux, and that was some... That was a disaster. That was seriously a disaster. It's amazing how the webcam is almost perfectly aligned. GMC, it's me, dude. I was just, you know, I'm pixel perfect. Yeah, thanks for joining us. Yeah, Surprise Attack Games. Yeah. Okay, I have 10 minutes to go, so let's see. There's something you can give a hand with. Some of those channels have been talking about the job you were investigating. Since you got the IP of the server the files were taken from. Can you see if you could get it for me? Just reply to this with the IP as additional text. I ran a simple track on him. Okay, so apparently we have to find an IP here. Oh, we don't have a shell. Let's use a shell. From Jameson's phone. This one is critical. Yeah, probably a couple of them is enough. Another trace, come on. God, this is the best password around ever. Yeah, I was caught by the hacker in the game. I really loved that bit, by the way. That was nice. I didn't like the fact that I cannot do anything about that, and I have no idea what is actually happening. But yeah, that would kind of be lovely to know, like, oh my god, something is happening, no, something is cracking me, or pressure is up. Yeah, I actually have 20 seconds and I'm talking. To be honest, I will not make it at all. DC. Ha, but I'm in. Actually, you know what? For the... I want to see what actually is happening when you're being caught. So, we'll definitely do that on stream. Let's see. Loot. There is a folder called Loot. And there's a text called Microsoft Docs. That's very safe. So the nice thing is that you actually have all the text in the console, so that's easy to 6182246. Unfortunately, you cannot send an email with the console, which is also Wait, am I reading the wrong... we got a CSEC invitation, okay. So this is the next group after Entropy, which you are playing with. And they are giving you more advanced tools and more advanced server and more advanced tasks, actually, to use with to complete. So they extended me the invitation and I have to pass a gauntlet. But I know that it will not have any trace. I wonder if I can do like this. Wow, so many logs. Chris Memories in 8-bit asks, how did you get the idea to make these OSs a hybrid between Linux and Windows? What do you mean insufficient? God damn it, I removed the wrong box. It was key unlocks. Oh, okay, this is nice. So I kind of hacked the box, but I can hack it again, and the trace is starting. So we can see what happens. Nice. I really just wanted to see what happens. And I, of course, disconnected. No! Okay. Now no disconnects. Okay. So actually, I wonder how big of a team did you have when creating this game? Linux. So the answer is kind of that Linux is scary to a lot of people, while Windows is familiar to most, and Mac is somewhere in between. Yeah. So. And Chris says, I love that game, it's very much reminiscent of Linux, but the BSOD threw me off. Mac and cheese is also popular. I'm not doing anything, I'm just waiting for Betrayed. Of course I could have copied my Xer. Kernel memory corruption. Did I see AT3DLL? Come on, guys. Oh, but no files were deleted, so I just was, what, rebooted? Okay, okay. This death was intentional. This death was intentional. Okay, so we basically are done here, and we almost reached the CSEC part of the game. But I already passed that in my game, but I messed up my save, which is oh well. But in this case, I cannot start the shell here. Can I start the shell here? Yep, I can. Oh, this is the firewall. Oh, okay, I will show you the firewall. This is like the... So, the firewalls will works like this. You run the analyze command. And it gives you this list of... rubbish words and rubbish characters. So in each line you actually have a solution to your firewall. This is an important bit. And every time you run analyze, it basically filters out unnecessary symbols. So you are left with uppercase solution. So the solution, as far as I saw, is always uppercase solution. And it's a simple word, so it's a readable word. So for example, right now I can do, and to solve, like, to pass the firewall, you have to solve this and guess this word, or just read this word, right? So this would be K-R-A-K-E-N. So it's Kraken, is it? It is. So, we have passed the firewall. So now we can do SSH crack. And we also can do SMTP overflow because this is much, much faster than the FTP one. And we can do port hack. The further you get, the more bad things happen. Yeah, I imagine. I imagine that it does happen. It kind of... I don't know. I don't know how to actually... well, for me, I'm also a software dev. I know a lot about Linux, and this is... For me, this is too easy. But I really, really understand where this game is going to. Apart from this interesting combination of different OSs, it's really, really nice thing to play with. And it's, I see this as a very kind of middle direction between Windows users and Linux users and advanced users and beginner users. And it's, is it the sweet spot? I don't know. I'm really, really not the one to judge from my point of view. But I think it gets, it has some interesting time to spend in this game. And especially, I hope that if you go deeper and deeper and deeper into the game, more interesting things happening, and I really mean more interesting things. It's not like, you know, someone is tracing me and I'm always getting a BSOD. Do I get a firewall? Can I upgrade something? Can I see that? Because I have no idea about this stuff. Also, I don't understand what is the ranking system in those contract bases, for example. It's like, I understand that I'm kind of raising, but what's the point of that? I don't know, right? These were like bits which I don't really get. Also, probably either because of the bug or something like that, I had music on the loop. I don't know how many songs there are in the game, but it kind of at the point was a bit repetitive for me. Yeah, so. That's it for me. I don't know if ChristyX4 is streaming on his channel. Probably on his channel, right? Yeah, so probably he's streaming Revenant. It was a very hard game to launch for us. So let me just go through the chat because chat is... chatting with Surprise Attack Games, which is very nice. Thank you really, really, really much for joining us here in our little family. Okay, so the Linux version is coming sometime. Okay. Alphador 7 says that this is like an easier version of Uplink, that game was hardcore. Yeah. Yeah, I could agree with this. It's a different concept of the game, but I could really, really agree with it. You know what? Let's do the raffle. Now, extra fast raffle. I'm not thinking where to open the... what? Let's do the raffle. I will just announce... raffle reset. Alright, reset, open the raffle. I'm opening the raffle. Write exclamation mark raffle to enter it. And this will be for a $9.99 code to spend on GOG.com, and probably you could buy this game with that code. Yes, so if you like this game, write exclamation I'm forgetting words. I'm sorry. It's just I had a brain freeze. Exclamation mark and raffle, and this is raffle boyos. And I will send the... Yeah, here it is. Send the code to someone who will win. Let's just type it in. Yeah, cool. So, raffle. We should make a song out of this. Remember the Jabber, Badger song? Badger, mushroom. Cool. Yeah, so basically this game is interesting. This game is a mix and match of very different parts of different systems. I really recommend to try this game because it opens an unexplored space for a lot of people who are not familiar with anything, with what is hacking, what are servers, what are ports, what is SMTP and etc. So if you don't understand these things, it's really, really nice to try it. If you do understand these things, unfortunately this game maybe is not for you. It's fun, but it's like too easy at the beginning, and for me it really, really was too easy at the beginning, and I kind of was, yeah, okay, so I'm just doing this automatically without any thinking. It's like nothing interesting is going on. But this is me. I'm really, really much more advanced, and cool. So thank you, Surprise Attack Games, for joining. Christy Explorer says, "What are servers, Team 17, circa during development of Worms World Part Remastered?" Yeah. Cool. So everyone entered. Shall I close the raffle and draw? Yes. I think everyone entered, and I'll just take 2 more minutes for this to end. Okay, so let's see. I think the game gets harder. So, okay, so ChristyX4 is actually streaming Revenant. Jump up into his own channel, and the winner is Garrett 24601, and I would say congratulations to him. You have just won a $9.99 code. Or GOG. So you can get this game or any other game however you want, man, however you want. So congratulations, Garrett. This is it today for me. I need a break, a really good one. Please join ChristyX4 in his channel. He will stream Revenant for you. Join us tomorrow starting from 2 p.m. GMT. We have a huge day tomorrow. Basically only releases are coming up. I will see you on my channel at Saturday night, and on Sunday during the Victor Vran co-op stream. Yeah, and I think that's it. Have a good night. Thank you very much for joining me. Please give Gokom channel a follow if you like what we are doing here. Please give me a follow also on Twitch or Twitter to if you like what I am doing. And I'm streaming on Saturday nights, 10 p.m. GMT on my channel. I have a little show where I try some new beers for me and play some games and just talk something. What pops into the mind after some alcohol injection. Right. That's it. I'm out. See ya.